Political analyst Raed Jarrar, who joins me in the studio. Great to have you with us. I want to just start by getting your reaction to this growing movement that we have seen in Iraq, particularly the fact that demonstrators have defied this government curfew and continued to demonstrate despite seeing some concessions.
It is a surprising new movement. It's very hard to explain, very hard to understand. I think politicians are caught off guard, because most of the movement are extremely young Iraqis who came to age after 2003. So it's a very different mentality, very different mindset, and no one really expected that they can be this organized, that they, hundreds of thousands of them would take to the streets without being under the control of the narrative of this government and its main political parties.
Speaking of the concessions that they made, I think the first was that it was dissolving these provincial councils that have been widely seen as corrupt, and lawmakers have also been pledging to reduce the salaries of high-ranking officials, including members of parliament themselves. We've seen these types of concessions. You almost think of Lebanon when you hear slashing the salaries and things like that, but it's really not enough, is it?
No, it's not enough. And from what I have seen and heard, the asks, what these demonstrators and protesters want, are not small tweaks on how this Iraqi government functions, but they really want to change the regime. And by the regime, they mean this sectarian, corrupt system that was installed in the country in 2003. So this is not about, you know, tweaking someone's salary or changing some administrative council to change its name. It's about changing the governance idea, the concept behind governing the country, that has been completely dysfunctional, that has failed to provide Iraqis with basic services in the last 15 or 16 years since its inception after the U.S. invasion. So I think the demand is way, way higher than what this government is willing to give.
We're hearing these growing calls for the prime minister to resign. What are the prospects for early elections?
I mean, today, the prime minister announced that he's not interested in early elections, and that's why a couple of main figures in Iraq, Shia political leaders, announced that they will call for a vote of no confidence. So it seems like we're heading towards more confrontation inside the government. But to tell you the truth, I think even with him resigning, or even with a vote of no confidence, I don't think that will be enough to satisfy what the Iraqi street wants now. People want a fundamental change in the way that the country is ruled. They want to end sectarianism. They want to end many of the foundational concepts of how Iraq has been ruled. It actually reminds me of what's going on in Lebanon.
Where is this movement going, and I guess how much control does the military have at this point in Iraqi forces, given the fact that there was a soldier that was killed today?
Not that much. And the situation in Iraq is complex, because you have the formal Iraqi military, but then you have on the side of that paramilitary groups and militias, mostly funded by Iran, that have been committing atrocities and human rights violations against Iraqis. So whether or not the former military has been attacking Iraqis or not is actually beside the point. The point that Iraqis are talking about in the last week or so is that they are under almost daily attacks by militias and paramilitary groups that are not affiliated directly with the Iraqi military. So the Iraqi military attacks against the military, and what you were mentioning earlier, are seen as completely separate than what Iraqis are dealing on a daily basis, dealing with pro-Iranian or Iranian-backed militias, mostly in the south of the country. And I don't think they view themselves to be in direct confrontation with their own country's former military yet.
We are certainly in an interesting period of time, given the growing protest movements around the world, not just in Iraq, but also in South America as well. Raed Jarrar, really appreciate your analysis. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.